I'm ready. Fine.
Are you sure?
It's hard not to look at yourself, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hey, y'all. What the fuck is tea, bitches? Yes, we are back up in this gig, and it's another episode of That's a Bop. Oh, yes. And I have a wonderful, wonderful guest. If you do not know who this wonderful man is sitting next to me, it's Emini K. Hello from the UK. Bitch, yes, you said that as an intro somewhere, bitch. Oh, yes. So if you've never heard of Emini K, I don't know. You have. And let me tell you how you have. Because, bitch, we probably have the same problem. So let me tell you what happened. So I was going through your music, right? And I said, oh, my God. Let's never forget you. I never knew what this is. I was like, what's that? You're not going through a discography. And then I played it. And I said, oh, I did not know that was you. I never knew. Mm-hmm. And I said, oh, bitch, that was you back there giving the vocal, coming in strong. I said, oh, yes. Do you know who Labyrinth?
Yes.
I love him. He's sick. That bitch can sing.
He's very talented.
Very talented. And that's what I thought it was at first when I first heard that song. And I was like, oh, yes. And then I was like, oh, okay.
Racism jumped out.
So usually on That's a Bop, we order food. That's the first thing.
Okay.
Priority is first.
I love it.
Yes. Now, what American brands have you had since being here?
Okay. So I've had things like Sweetgreen, Tender Green, Boston
Nova. You had Tender
Green? Yeah.
So how did that go for you?
I like Tender Green. It's good for like a healthy moment. You know what I mean? Like, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Boston Nova. Like, what else? Like, Roscoe's.
You had Roscoe's?
I've had Roscoe's.
How did you like?
I do like Roscoe's.
Okay.
I feel like it's better when you go in the restaurant.
Though. Yeah, I never had it to go. We did have it to go. It's definitely better in the restaurant. The to go was not cute. Speaking of chicken, have you had Buffalo Wild Wings?
No.
Good. You have. That's so shady! Have you had Wingstop?
I haven't had Wingstop. I've heard of it, but I've never.
You've heard of her. You know her presence. Usually, I let the artist choose the food. But because you're from the UK, and I need you to have this experience with me, we're going to have Wingstop. I need you to know how serious this is. Okay. Wingstop. She's like the Beyonce of the wing industry.
Oh.
Yes. Well, what are you saying? Yes. I don't know what you're talking about at home, but that's how I feel. You tell me who else is giving the wings. Buffalo Wild Wings, girl, please. Even though she's a good competitor. She's a good competitor, Buffalo Wild Wings, she is. I know Buffalo Wild Wings chicken. I've had her too many times. Wingstop came through and she said, oh girl, give me that wig of yours. And I'll
take it.
I'll take your wig. And I'll put it in a bag. And I'll keep it for my safekeeping. Just like
can
that.
Can it have like a cutaway to me like taking a wig off your head?
Oh my God, yes. But... Can you give me a wig over there, Kenneth? Which wig?
Oh, wow.
Which wig was like the snap?
This is the pink one.
Yeah. There it is. So what people do not know about you, and I think that people need to know, is that you're a phenomenal writer, AKA you wrote Hold Up for Beyonce. Can we get into that? I think people need to know.
Yeah.
Hello.
Wait, I feel like I'm about to sneeze. It's a false one.
Hey, it's such a shame. You let this good love go to waste. The top tip, 5-star, 50-11, in the car, like, make that wood, highly like a boulevard. Bitch, you did that. You made that a kind of transition, bitch, for the Rachel World Tour. Yeah, you did that. Without that part, that transition would not be the same. And the fact that you wrote for girls like Little Mix, Zara Larsson, which I love Zara Larsson, she's so sickening. You wrote Touch, right?
I produced Touch.
I live that. I produced Touch. So you did Touch, you did a strip.
Co-produced on Strip.
Bitch, that's so sickening. I have to get into that. Real quick, I just have to feel that. I do. I have to feel that right there. Absolutely.
Take off all my makeup.
This.
Because I love what's on.
The fact that you are even a part of this is sickening. I think that this was cut. Ooh, I know a girl that looked like this. I know a couple of girls from Detroit that look like this. Absolutely.
Take off all my makeup, cause I love what's under it.
Bitch, I'm a sick. I stand. So it's just like, bitch, you have like a slippery slope. And first of all, the reason why this is like monumental for me and I want to highlight this is because you're fucking LGBT. You're part of the club. You're part of the girls. You know what I mean? You're proud as fuck. And it's like to see you do magnificent things like this. You know what I mean? And like, bitch, just be so talented and be like, you know, I just do me. I just do me. I just, I do what I do. care for the girls. You know what I mean? And I think that is so sick because you're so humble about it.
Aww.
No, real shit. Like, you're like legit like, oh, well, you know. Yeah, I did that. I mean, but you know, nothing.
Well,
I mean,
like, listen, like, I'm here, I'm doing, I get to do what I love. Like, same way, like, you get to be here and being yourself and like just expressing yourself.
Yeah.
Like, it's just my own medium of doing that.
Yeah.
And so, like, whether it's like writing for other people or like, you know, doing my own records, like, mm-hmm. it's like, it's fun for me.
Yeah.
So I'd rather be happy.
Okay. Okay. First of all, this video is, if you haven't seen the girlfriend video, actually, I'm not going to ruin it. You have to go watch it because, bitch, the tippity tip at the end is like, ooh. But yes, the lyrics is what, like, I think every gay man goes through this. Like, at least one time. You live for me, but, like, you're not even out.
But you know what? The thing is, like, this may be, like, appropriative. This is not from my own experience. This is one song. Why this isn't even from someone I've gone through, but I wrote it because, especially in our community, right?
Yeah.
It's just such a like prominent thing.
Yeah.
Like, I have so many friends I have played to, and they're like, oh my god, I've been through this. Yeah. Like, oh my god.
I was like, well, yes, I know this.
All right, baby, you got a little.
What?
All right.
Like, is it one of the wig hairs? Well, you know she sheds.
Chick wine.
Y'all got some hot wings around here? The food is here. This is the moment we waited for. You about to get into Wingstop.
I'm ready.
Are you excited?
Mm.
Okay. Dun da 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 da. And then bum 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 bum. Somebody wrote dope videos. That is so cute. Somebody that work at Wingstop watches the videos. Thank you. Oh, that is so cute. I never had somebody leave me a note in my food before. That is so nice. I'm gonna keep that.
See, now you're gonna be asking for discounts.
I'm gonna feel like, who said I got dope videos? Can I have a discount on my wings, girl, please? So who produced this track?
I produced it.
The whole thing? This is what I'm saying.
You know, because look, Spotify has
the song credits.
Yes.
Damn. Boom, boom, boom. I love how this, you go to his song credits.
And that's my friend Ryan. He's my good Judy.
The good Judy that we were
so
talking
he's
about.
He helped write a bunch of songs. He helped write Honey Moon Phase as well. Sorry.
We gotta get there. We haven't got there yet. Here are the fries. They are sickening. If you are you a fry?
Yeah.
Are you part of the fry club?
Yeah.
Like, bitch, I can just eat a fry and I'm okay?
Yeah.
Now I'm on keto, so I can't have fries. And I'm over it. The vital thing, their ranch. Wingstop, what do you put in your ranch? Cocaine? I don't know. She's addictive. Her ranch is nothing to play with. So I got garlic parm and I got Louisiana rub. Those are my gigs. And because they don't have any carbs in them, it's just dry rub and chicken. So I get my protein and everything else and above. So. Either you or your story's
straight.
That's
such
a shame.
That's a read. It's a nothing new about me and you, about what we do. Tell me what will she do?
Yeah. If I
just told the truth and said the word, someone like her just isn't right for you. Cause you're
look. I'm trying to say that cause you're good. But you wanted to say, you know.
Yeah, because you're good, get. But okay, we'll move on. We'll move on, because baby, you don't get it. But that, like I said, that was a read when you said, bitch, neither you or your story straight.
That's everyone's favorite lyric.
Because it's like, yes, that's a read. That is a read. If somebody told me that, bitch, neither you or your story is straight.
I've been to your house, that's why you always come back.
I want to be like,
right.
I just want to be like in a, like an old girl group. Like this, it gives that for me. Like I just want to be like in a fisheye lens, like. Yeah, the fisheye lens, exactly. Sing. No bitch's hair to look like this and it don't move. And I'm not even gonna do y'all like this, but bitch, I know two bitches off top of my head. Look at that. I am doing a lot of movement. She back there.
Stiff walk. Stiff there. Stiff everywhere.
That bitch is like, girl, what are you talking about? What do you mean? And I know a bitch that had a wig like this. I thought they was the shit too. Okay. I like to ask people's studio time. Like, what do they do before they walk into a studio and they record a bop like that? Like, what do you do? Like, what is your preparation? What are you giving? Or do you just go right in and be like, if your girlfriend knew what we do? girl.
No, okay, so like with this, right, it was, I don't know, the song I developed in like different stages, right? Mm-hmm. So it started out with just a chorus. I had the chorus. Uh-huh. And then I was just like writing like lyrics, mm-hmm. just like lyrics with it, like with Ryan. Mm-hmm. And then I just kind of like spent some time on it and just pieced it together. Mm-hmm. And so I don't know, it was just like, and the main thing was like the melody of the chorus. I was like, I wanted to sort of like do Ana Querida.
Yeah.
And thankfully we were able to clear it.
Yes.
We stand a clearance.
We do. We do. We live for a clearance.
And yeah.
You had the fries already. Uh-huh. Did you dip it in ranch? You're not eating it right. Dip her in the ranch. Uh-huh.
Oh, wow.
Ah! Bitch, I'm living for you! This is a perfect segue. Do you know why? Because this food makes me this happy. This why.
The wings bring color to my life. Okay.
The wings brought color to my life. Bitch, before, everything was black and white. And then she came along.
Before you came into my life, everything was black and white. And now I see it's color. You bring color to my life, baby. Uh-huh.
Girl, 2 + 2.
Mm. 1
equals 2. Yeah.
Ready? Can you help me?
I got you.
Okay.
This is so sickening to me, because it was just like, y'all got me fucked up, bitch. If you wanna come to me, you wanna get it to me, you got to come correct, girl. Period.
Hey.
The way you tell me you're okay. Not doing the best, so come.
This like almost Latin-y feel to it, almost.
Yeah.
It's like got some horns back there, you know. I'm getting into it, and it's like this tambourine almost sound in the back, and it's like it has like this spiciness, like it's like a bitch, but it's like, girl, you know what I mean?
Mm.
So, did you produce this one too, huh?
Yeah.
So, what was your inspiration? Like, what was like to make you like? What made you be like, bitch? I need to make a song, but you need to come correct.
So, like, basically, right? I have a complex about like bigging myself up, mm-hmm. or like acknowledging like things I've been a part of.
Mm.
I've had like a long career, and I've been able to like work with people that like I idolize,
yeah.
and that I love.
That's,
you know?
Amazing.
And yet, even sometimes, I still struggle to be like, you know, oh, like, yeah, like, this is it, this is what I do, you know what I mean? And, or, like, I'm that bitch or whatever. So, like, it's cool to have, like, a song that I can play that mm-hmm. with, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, also, it's, I'm not lying, like, you know what I mean? This is what I've done, and this is, I have to claim it, right? So, no one can take that away from me. When you've done that, no one can take it away from me, and that's, like, what I was learning with the song. A very good show. Thank you.
You live for the show?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want
to. Wait, let me try the wings.
Uh-huh. Mm. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, wing stop. Wow. Wow. Wow.
I got Korean spicy barbecue. Mm-hmm. And I also got Hawaiian as well. Okay. I reckon that this is gonna be the Korean spicy barbecue.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Wing stop is cut.
This is great.
All I see is left of my life.
You have a great sound system.
You said what?
You have a great sound system.
Well, thank you. You know, that's one of the reasons like we got this house. We was looking at it and I said, what do these do up there? And they were like, speakers. I said, for the house, I have to have this.
Mm.
How was it working with Hailee Steinfeld, by the way?
She's lovely. Such a nice person.
Yeah, I know she came out on your LA show.
She did, which you were there.
Mm-hmm. You performed so fucking well.
Thank you very much.
Your dancers. I stan your dancers. Like, absolutely.
Thank you. I'm sure you know some of them.
I do, yeah. Do know some of them.
The premise of them, because when I started that, the album campaign and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I said I wanted 4 dancers, but then I wanted it to be like 4 gay black boys.
Who,
like,
love that.
Who like went in and out of like femme and mask, mm-hmm. and like the main premise was really to be a less racist version of the Harajuku girls.
I never thought that I would need anybody.
Come on, bitch. Bone apple tea. Ah! Before you came into my life! Bitch! Yeah! Yes.
Hey, baby. Hey. Hey, you. Before you came into my
goddamn
life. Before you came into my goddamn life.
Before
you came into my life. Girl, everything was goddamn black and white. did you hear me?
That's how I feel like you were saying it.
Here we are. This is ridiculous. This show, I don't know what the hell this show is. I really don't. Oh, this show is a mess. This show is a fucking mess.
Okay, now that you've had Wingstop, what do you give her?
I'm gonna give her...
Will you miss her in the UK?
I am gonna miss her in the UK.
Okay.
Wait.
Do you have Wingstop in the UK?
I think we do. I think we might.
What chicken places do you have in UK?
Literally like bootleg chicken places. Like, or like, you know, not like, but like boss man chicken you can get anywhere.
Really?
But I don't know. Anyway, Wingstop is a bop.
Yes! You heard it here. I want to take us back. You know, we were full. We went down your career. I want to tell the people when I met you.
Okay.
So you were all types of other names than what you really are when I first met you. You have that problem. You have that problem commonly, right?
Yeah.
And but how you even had like in the intro of your album, you had like this girl like in the club or some shit like, oh my God, I love him. He's so good. It's like McCain. And it's like the girl was like, girl, Manique, girl. I love that's the intro of your album.
I wanted to do that because, well, the album's called Language.
Yeah.
And I think like so much of it is about being misunderstood.
Yeah.
And I thought like, you know, when I was writing the album, I was thinking about all of the other things I was being misunderstood about. But then when I finished it, I was like, one of the biggest misunderstandings of me is my name.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Swimming pool of passion, mutual attraction. We both know there is something going on. Say who's? There is something going on. We didn't want to stop this first. With those three little words. We both know there is something going on. But I don't want to say it wrong. Say, no, I don't want to say it. No, I don't want to say it. I don't know how you'll say it. So I'm going to try not to say it.
Because when I said it in the goddamn past, girl, everybody laughed. I loved it. Bitch, when I tell the goddamn you that needs a Grammy.
Ooh, there it is.
Swimming pool of passion, mutual attraction. We both know there is something going on. There is something going on. Didn't wanna stop this verse. With those three little words. Cause we both know there is something going on. But I don't wanna play it wrong. So I'm not gonna say it. No, I don't wanna say it. I don't know how you'll take it. So I'ma try not to say it. Cause when I've said it in the past, each time it didn't last. So I'ma try not to say it. But it feels like I might say it. So I'm putting both hands over my mouth. I can only hope nothing's gonna come out. But there it is on the tip of my tongue. Think you're the one.
I remember even listening to Barney and shit. Like, he's like, ooh, bitch, I love that melody.
Love Barney.
Yeah, he had box.
I love you. You love me. Why did I sing that as Louis Armstrong?
Yeah, it was Louis Armstrong. Yes, bitch. I was about to be like, girl, what in the Ray Charles Louis that? Armstrong?
I don't know where that came from. Thank you for doing this.
What? What do you mean?
Be sweet of you.
What?
It's very nice of you.
What? Because I live for you. I legit. Let me tell you something. I legit live because I think that, one, I remember you went on a rant not so long ago on your Instagram. You said people need to start supporting the LGBT artists. And I think that was very, really important. And I was like, that's real shit. I was like, bitch, if you want us to be popping, if you want us to be ahead, then bitch, if you support your fellow LGBT artists, then bitch, we will be there.
I would like to add to that point though, however.
Go ahead.
Because I acknowledge that by saying simply that, it puts blame on music buyers. When it's not like, it's not just their fault that it's not happening, you know what I mean? It's like, there's labels involved, there's corporations, there's people who are funding these artists. Like, you know, obviously we can only do so much as artists, and the fans can only do so much as buyers to a very niche, you know, group of artists.
Yeah.
So like, it goes two ways. It goes with labels believing in LGBTQ artists, like management, and you know, the people who are giving all these labels money to really believe that an LGBTQ artist can actually go all the way
and actually sell
and do the damn thing
and do tours like you just did,
and it be like a really like queer thing. It's not like it's gonna be like
whitewashed. No shade. Just being honest.
If that is what it is, yeah. You know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
That's not what I'm saying.
I know. But like, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying that. I'm saying that. Now we're sitting around asking when I have so many. Oh, this song. It's so beautiful. And I'm really happy you left it on the album because it almost didn't make the album, correct?
Well, not that it almost didn't make the album. It was always going to be in the album. I was just going to be like, yeah, fuck it. Like, yeah. It's there. There were people who were like, it wasn't in within.
All the other shit, like.
Other shit, they were like, maybe it's too long. Maybe it's too indulgent.
Mm. It is a long song on the album.
It's a very long song.
But you have to realize, and this is what I love that you said, that Janelle Monáe's Arc Android is like your inspiration for this album.
One of the inspirations for this album, like. Arc Android, I love the album.
That's Velvet, one of my favorite albums.
Velvet Rope by Janet was the inspiration.
Oh, I can hear that, yeah.
That was an absolute like, inspiration for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Writings on the Wall.
Of course.
So it was all like those albums and obviously just and like my favorite thing about pop music.
And it gave birth to this. It's like we used to, whatever happened to me and you, taking us right out of the honeymoon phase. All right. Let me give you the picture. Yeah! No big deal. Explaining how I feel. I don't know why and it's taking us so long. Why it's taking us so long? So much hesitation for that kind of conversation. We both know there is something going on now, but we don't wanna play wrong. So I'm not gonna say it. I don't know how you take it, so I'ma try not to say it. When I said it, we'll go back. Each time it didn't last, so I'ma try not to say it. But it feels like I'm messing up.
It's that kind of song.
If you want to walk on the treadmill, bitch, this is the song, bitch. Taking us right out of the yeah!
I love how you like know all the little details.
Let me tell you something. I listen to music so differently than a lot of people.
I see that, honestly.
Yeah, like, I legit, like, when even when I do my reactions and stuff, and I, like, when people be like, well,
you're why do you pause and all that stuff?
Always.
Because you're deep in, like, every little
I
thing.
I have to. Because I feel like, as an artist, when you produce this kind of stuff, it's appreciative. Like, if I was a painter, and, bitch, you realized every little stroke and something spoke to you, as a consumer, you as an artist, you want to hear that. You like, I'd be like, bitch, yeah? Well, how do you? Yes! People in the studio, like when you're in the studio with your friends and writing and producing this bop, it's like, oh, that little bop, I need that little part right there. I need that, put that in there. But like, it goes over so many people's heads. You know what I mean? But as a musician, you're like, bitch, oh, that part right there, you know? And that's why I'd be like, bitch, I gotta pause. Cause I need my audience, like, bitch, get into this. And I think that I'm so happy that the people that do watch me, they're like, oh, bitch, we know if we watch you, bitch, we're gonna get into the gig. We're gonna get into the music. We're gonna know the beat patterns, bitch. We're gonna know the drum kit the bitch used. Well, I've sweated through my 4X shirt, and I want to thank you for coming on That's a Bop.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. You're absolutely amazing. I can't wait to see what else you come up next. I'll be there.
I'm going to keep you posted.
If you've not followed my baby, please do. This album, if you saw, I just sweated my whole life away. It is absolutely amazing. And I leave you guys with the rest of this hairography. And I love you guys for watching, as always. Tired Ass Army, you guys are the shit. And I will catch you guys on the next That's a Bop. Yes. No, I'm not trying to see it. No, I don't want to see it. I'ma try not to see it. But it feels like I might say it. So. I'm putting both hands over my mouth. Nothing's gonna come out. I'm the tip of my tongue. I think I love you. I think.